Marcelo Silva is a journalist when the book starts, or and then he becomes a former journalist because he starts working on the side of the public investigation of economic crimes in Lisbon. He is a person who does not work for because of the money, because he has a prosperous background, so he is rather rich, so he doesn't need to work, but he feels responsible for to change things that are going wrong. And from failure to failure, at the end, he succeeds, and it is not necessarily his merit. The old plot of the book, I think it has a part that is a criminal investigation, it has a part that is a love story, and it has a lot to do with the personal relationships with between journalists and people who live in Lisbon, all kind of people who live in Lisbon. But insofar he has a lot in common with me. And also regarding the plot, it is about many stories I investigated as a journalist in the course of 30 years that I could not publish for various reasons. One of the reasons was maybe sometimes the reason was I didn't have facts enough to write journalistically about it. Other times it was because there was pressure from influential people who didn't want it to be published. And that's also kind of a definition of journalism, which we can apply to literature and to the polar literature also, that journalism is to publish something that somebody doesn't want to be published. Everything else is advertisement or propaganda or advertisement, I'd say. Starting with me, I know Lisbon since I'm a very small child, as I was born in South Portugal, and I went to Lisbon very often with my grandfather, who was the mayor of Faro, that's the capital city in the south. And as a mayor, he had very often to go to the ministry in Lisbon, and I went with him many times. So I know the city since I'm very small. But then I only came back to Lisbon when I was already 24 years old, and or 25. And then I started to live in Lisbon, and I thought, what a big city here, it's fantastic, it's everything is anonymous. And then I came to know the city, and the city is not really big, everyone knows everyone, all the people are somehow linked to each other, and I came to the conclusion that I myself have like 43 cousins who live in Lisbon, and many of whom I didn't of which I didn't know about. So it's a particular charm of Lisbon is that it's very touristical, but there is still a very native network that no tourist sees. And that was also one of my ideas, to show this other Lisbon that is not touristical. There is the tendency to always show the yellow streetcars and the fado singers, and when they make any kind of movie or book or whatever about Lisbon. And that is not false. So the particular thing about clichés is that they are not necessarily false. They are not false. A cliché is not necessarily false, but it's just a way to look at things exactly the way all the other people have looked at it. And you just give again what everyone has written before. And I think with a deep knowledge of Lisbon, I went much deeper, because I see things as a person who lives in Lisbon for over 25 years now. I see things and that a tourist does not see, and it's not and the city has much more to offer It has a kind of strange solidarity, rich people living next to very poor people, sometimes in the same buildings. Well, there is a particular life to Lisbon that makes it a very exotic city. And it's not necessarily a coincidence that when many people from France, who usually went to Marrakesh to see a very exotic city, and then after 2001, slowly Lisbon was discovered because it's a very exotic city beneath the surface. Crime fiction makes you get the attention of people if you tell something through crime fiction. You have many examples of that. So my family comes from, I am Portuguese, but I'm also German. My family is from Austria and from the Czech Republic. I have a grandmother who was born and is Catalan from near Barcelona. So I feel as an European, really. But especially like Portugal, and I have a lot of family there, and I very often compare it to Germany, that is my other half. And in Germany, the most important institution in fiction and in the German television is a serial called Tatort, that means local of the crime, scene of the crime. And it exists for more than 40 years every Sunday. And it's, so to say, the last common bonfire people sit around to see. Everyone in Germany sees this Tatort every Sunday, a new crime story. And all the important topics of life in society, whatever it is, ecology or pedophiles or human traffic or gender equality, it's all told through fiction, through criminal fiction, because it has the capacity to get people's attention. And so it's also very high responsibility to use criminal fiction, because you can make it cheap and cliche and just on the surface, or you can try and do it better.